are you? Hello. Good to see you all again.
How are you?
So good to see all of you.
Yeah.
Hope you had a good time over these 5 weeks learning about Paul, the amazing Paul. You know, Paul is an amazing man, and I think, you know, there's still more things, still more stories. That's the great thing about the Bible. There's always more stories.
Always. As a matter of fact, I mean, think about some of the stories we talked about. You know, we talked about Paul being as physically as he was. We were talking about how deep water affects us and where Jesus can be with. We talk about God himself and what he has for us, and then friends.
Yeah.
Can't have that.
Got friends are friends forever.
That's right.
If the Lord's the Lord of them.
Speaking about a friend, I'm looking into the back there. You guys can't see it, but I can. Looks like one of PB's friends just showed up.
Yeah, I think one of our friends is going to be with us
at the
closing session. Like she's been, he's been with us through some of the other closing sessions.
There you go. There's a secret for you.
Well, what about that verse there, Vern? John 3:17.
So in John 3:17, if you know John 3:16, this is a follow-up for that. And in John 3:16, of course, it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever ever believe in him will not perish but have everlasting life." Now we follow along with that in 17. It says, "For God didn't send the Son into the world to judge the world, but instead that we, the world, might be saved through him."
That's amazing. Have you been saved, Vern?
Yes. Yes, I have.
Can you tell us about your salvation?
I remember as a kid, I was about 13 years old, and just remember talking with, my father was in the military, so we had chaplains.
That's cool.
And not pastor, but anyway, it was a chaplain that came to me. His name was John Gideon. We won't say that again, but Pastor John told me, he said, "Vern," he said, "do you believe in Jesus?" And I said, "Well, I've heard all of these stories about him and everything, but I want to know more about him. I really need to know more about him." And so we talked, and for weeks we talked about this, and I finally told him, I said, "That's really all I have to do?" I said, "I know I feel him around me, but all I have to do is just open my heart and say, 'Jesus, I want you to come in.'" He said, "Yeah, it's that simple." I said, "It can't be that simple."
Yeah.
He says, "Well, no, it is." He says, "But you have to remember, though, there's going to be this, what he called a challenge. And the challenge is to have Jesus in your heart, but also let Jesus change your mind."
Yeah.
And the one thing he told me off the bat, he said, "Vernon, don't be 18 inches away from heaven." And I said, "Well, what does that mean? I'm a 13-year-old. He says, "That is the distance from your head to your heart."
That's pretty neat.
I said, "Okay, so what I should believe in my heart, right, should also change my mind then? Is that what you're saying?" He said, "Exactly." He says, "The change occurs inside your body, but it changes your mindset too." And I said, "Wow."
That's pretty interesting.
That was something. So anyway, that's what I did. I accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior, and it hasn't always been easy. You know, as a sheep, I'm always wanting to go to the left or the right, and my Lord and Savior Jesus, as the Good Shepherd, is always, you know, using his rod and staff to move me around and where he wants me to be at. But there is nothing in this world that I can say that has been better than my relationship with Jesus Christ.
Well, that's great.
Because of that.
That's really good to hear.
But, you know, I've never talked to you about it, but I know as a pastor at some point in time, Jesus had to come into your life too.
Yes. Well, I was about 10 years old, and I had been wanting to become a Christian for a long time, but I needed to understand some things. One of the things I needed to understand was not only that God loved me and that I loved God, but I needed to understand repentance. I needed to understand that I needed to ask for forgiveness for my sins. And about the time I understood that, we had a revival in Oklahoma City at the 89er Bar Ballpark. And a preacher preached, and it was kids' night, so we had a lot of kids there. I went told my dad I needed to go down and accept Jesus as my Savior. So we went down, and we met with my pastor. When I was 10 years old, my pastor was about as tall as I was, because he was a real short man. But we met on the pitcher's mound at 89er Ballpark, and when I told him what I needed to do, he knew I pretty much understood it, and we talked, and I said, you know, I needed to do what the Bible says. I needed to realize I was a sinner, and that I needed God's forgiveness of my sins, and that really importantly, I needed to realize that Jesus had died on a cross for my sins, paid the penalty for my sins, rose again on the third day, and that it wasn't anything I could do. I couldn't get baptized, or I did get baptized, but baptism was just a symbol of what I'd done, and that I couldn't just go to church a whole bunch and get everything right, but that I had to come to Jesus exactly how I was, and that was a sinner in need of God. And he came in, when that happened, he became my Savior, the one who forgives me of my sins, and he became my Lord. In other words, he became the boss of my life, and so now I'm supposed to obey him, not because I'm trying to make him like me anymore, because I can't. He likes me enough. But I really need to do that, because the Bible says if we will confess that Jesus Christ died on a cross for our sins, rose again on the third day, the Bible says we'll be saved.
You will be saved, yeah. And that's one thing that I had to come to know within my own testimony too, is what was sin?
Yeah.
I had to understand that, because, you know, I see the rest of the world as an example, and I said, well, I'm doing what they're doing, and that's just the point. I'm not supposed to be doing what the world is doing.
No, we're supposed to be different.
Yeah, we're supposed to be set apart. Jesus calls to us and moves us over into the other group. It's kind of like when you're in school where the teacher calls you up to the front row. The reason why is because I was hanging out back with all the comedians in the back.
Yeah.
But she moved me up to the front to set me apart from them so I could be one of those people who learn.
Yeah. And you can really only live for Jesus if you have Jesus in your life.
That's right.
So that's important. Kids, if y'all want to know some more things about that, you say, I just don't really understand all that, and I want to understand it more. I feel like God wants me to be saved. Would you either call the church or put something on our website at northirving.org and just say, I would like to talk with somebody more about becoming a Christian. And we would love to talk with you more about it, because I really want you to understand it. Really want you to understand it before you become a Christian.
Yeah, let us know anything, that any question we could have. I know you're going to have a million questions about it, as we all did in our own walk. But that is the greatest part about it. You know, you can ask God anything, and he will answer.
Right.
God will give you the answer. Sometimes it may not be the answer you want, but it's still an answer. Amen.
That's right. And we're all praying for you that these different videos have reached you, and hopefully that you'll come to Christ because of them, because that's why we do what we do. So hopefully you have listened, learned, and we will see you, Vern and I, at closing session with our special green friend.
That's right, man. You guys be great, okay? Bye now.
Bye.
Hi, boys and girls. You've done it. We're on week 5. I'm so excited. It's good to have you. We hope that you've had a great time. I want to kind of recap our stories of Saul Paul. Now, remember when we started, Saul was a bad guy. He wanted to kill the Christians. He thought it was his right to do that because they were following a false teacher that they called Jesus. Now, we know better than that, but that's what Saul was doing. So he was walking along, remember on the road to Damascus that PB talked about? Remember that? All of a sudden, a bright light stopped him, and he fell off his animal, and he didn't know what was happening, and he heard the light say, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Persecuting is a fancy word for, why are you doing this to me? And who was the one speaking? Well, Saul found out later that was Jesus. And he didn't know what was happening, so he went into town, and a couple of days later, his eyes were fixed and he could see, and he then knew what he wanted to do. His goal was to tell as many people as he could about Jesus, and the rest of his life, he's working towards that goal. So remember, PB also talked about the time when he was in a city, and the city people found out that he was talking, that he was trying to get them, so he had to get away fast. So remember, his friends put him in a big basket and lowered him over, and Paul was able to escape, and they couldn't find him. So the next story will start in just a second. Welcome back. Miss Sherry told you the story about Paul in Athens. And people in Athens had lots of gods. They had a sun god and a moon god and all these other gods. They even had a guy like this that was to the unknown god. Now, Paul was able to use that and say, hold on a minute, there is no unknown God, there's only the one true God, and that's the one we're supposed to worship. And that's what Paul was trying to do. So eventually he's going to get to tell everybody about Jesus, the one true God. Now, next in Paul's life, he was trying to get from one place to the other, and he was in a storm. Miss Sherry told you about the storm, and things were really, really bad. Well, he survived that shipwreck, and then another time he was in a shipwreck, and the sailors were also scared. They thought the boat was going to break apart, but Paul said, it's okay. My God's going to protect us, and he told me that all of us are going to survive. We're not going to lose any people or any of our cargo. And guess what? That's exactly what happened. Now, the ship didn't survive very much, but all the people and the cargo survived. So while they were on this island, Paul was picking up some firewood. And you know, there's one thing I hate more than anything in this world, and those are snakes. And Paul reached down to get some firewood, and a snake bit him. And the people thought, oh my goodness, this was a deadly snake. And Paul just kind of shook it off and was fine. Nothing happened to him. His hand didn't swell up, it didn't fall off, none of that stuff. Well, the people were so surprised, they wanted to worship God, but worship Paul as if he was a god. And Paul said, time out. I'm not a god, but let me tell you about the one true God. Here again, Paul has an opportunity to tell people about Jesus. And that was his only goal. He made all sorts of missionary journeys. He wrote lots of books in our New Testament, including one called Romans. Now, Miss Kathy's going to read us some verses out of Romans. And the first one is Romans 3:23. Miss Kathy, what does Romans 3:23 say?
Romans 3:23 says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Now, what is sin? Sin is all the bad stuff that we do. Now, I do bad stuff. Do you guys do bad stuff? Now, bad stuff may not be stuff that they put you in jail for, but it could be stuff like taking a cookie when you're not supposed to, or telling that little white lie, oh yeah, my room's clean, when all you did was stuff the stuff under the bed. Those are all bad things, and God doesn't like sin. In fact, in heaven, there will be no sin, so we needed a way to get to heaven, and we can't do it with sin in our lives. So, Miss Kathy, what does Romans 5:8 say?
Romans 5:8 says, but God demonstrates his own love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Now, the reason that Paul has great stories to tell is because he talks about Jesus. Now, we celebrate Christmas because that's when Jesus came as a baby in a manger in Bethlehem. And we all love that story. For Easter, we celebrate something that's not quite as fun. When Jesus grew up, some bad people took him and they put him on a cross because they thought he was doing bad things. But in fact, Jesus did nothing wrong. He never did anything that was sin. He never told a lie to his mommy. He never talked bad to his brothers and sisters. He was perfect, but he's the only one. And they crucified him. They put him on a cross and he died. But our story doesn't end there, does it? No. On Easter, and we celebrate this every year, he rose again. After 3 days, the ladies went to the tomb and he wasn't there. And that's because he came back to life. He beat sin. So, Miss Kathy, what does Romans 6:23 say?
Romans 6:23 says, for the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
That's exactly right. So when Jesus came, he came as a ransom, or he paid the price for us. Now, your mommies and daddies may work, and when they work, they get wages. And that's payment for what the work that they've done. So Jesus came to take our punishment. Normally when we take that cookie or we tell a white lie, sometimes we have to go to time out, or we may have to give the cookie back, or we may not get cookies the next time. Well, Jesus did that. Jesus took our sins so that we don't have to be punished for them. That doesn't mean we're not going to sin some more, but this way we're forgiven. Now, do you remember the ABCs? And I don't mean the ABCDs that we sing, but the ABCs. First is A. Faith, what does A stand for?
Admit.
Admit to God that you're a sinner. That's exactly right. We have to know that we're sinners. And we all know that we do bad things. Even adults do bad things. B is what, Faith?
Believe.
We have to believe that what? That Jesus is who? God's son, right?
Right.
Good job, Faith. And C, this is another big word. We have to confess our sins. We have to tell people, you know what? I sinned, but God forgives us every single time. So, Miss Kathy, what does Romans 10:9 say?
I like this verse, Miss Laurie. Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with your mouth Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved.
Everybody who asks is saved?
Anybody who asks and believes in their heart.
That's exactly right. So we can do that, and it's not hard. If I was to give you a gift, you would be willing to take it, right? Well, that's what Jesus did. He gave us the best gift ever. Because he came and he died and he rose again, he took our sin, and all we have to do is ask him to forgive us. So in your sack today, you're going to find a little Ziploc bag with a bracelet in it. It's not a bracelet yet, but let me show you what you're going to do. There's a little card that kind of helps us. So in your bag, you're going to find a green pipe cleaner and some beads. Now, the beads tell the story that Paul wanted everybody to know. The first one is a black bead, and that tells us that reminds us that we're all sinners and that God doesn't like sin. But then the red bead is for the blood that Jesus shed that covered up our sins. The white bead that's next shows what happens to our hearts after Jesus died for us and after we ask him to come in. He cleans our heart as white as snow. Blue is to remind us of our baptism. Now, baptism is a fancy word for something that we can do after we ask Jesus to come into our heart, where we symbolize and show everybody else what we've done. The water is in the baptistry. We can either do it in a river, or I've even seen it in a horse trough, or in a baptistry. There's nothing magical about the water. There's no sparkly glitter in the water. It's not magic. It's just water. But it's a symbol of washing away our old life where we're sinners and coming back up. We have a new life in Jesus, and we can go to heaven forever to be with him. The green bead is to help us to remember that we need to grow in God's love. We can now tell people about Jesus. That's why we do Vacation Bible School, so we can tell everybody and all of the children, all of our friends, what Jesus can do for us. The yellow bead is to remind us that we can go to heaven, because now that we have Jesus in our heart, we get to go to heaven to be with him. So when we pass away or when he comes back, we'll go live with him in heaven, and that'll be great because there's no sin in heaven, and there'll be fried chicken and all sorts of things that we don't get to have on earth now because they're not good for us. So that'll be a fun time. The purple bead is to remind us that even during COVID, Jesus is still king. Now, we may have to wear masks at home, at school, if we go back to school, and masks when we go out into public, but you know what? God sees us anyway, and those masks don't mean anything to him. So remember, we love you, Jesus loves you, and it's very simple to accept Jesus. All you have to do is ask, and he's more than willing to accept you. Thanks so much, and have a great time.
Hi, boys and girls. This is our last week of our SAC Vacation Bible School, and we're so glad you decided to join us. We're going to be learning our last Bible verse for the week, and let's call our good friend Beverly so she can help us. You ready? Beverly! There she is. Hi, Beverly.
Hi.
Is your hand or your arm better this week?
Yep.
Good. I am so glad. Have you been brave enough to get back on your bicycle again?
No.
Not yet?
Not yet.
Okay. Well, it'll come. You will be. Now, did you have any, were you scared last week at all of the dark after we learned our new Bible verse? You were? Did you maybe say the Bible verse in your head?
Yes.
Did it help?
Yes.
It did. Boys and girls, did you know that when you learn Bible verses and when you hide them in your heart, when you have them in your head and they're also in your heart, you can remember those Bible verses in times when you're afraid or mad or scared, or you just need to be reminded that you have God on your side. So that's why we like to remember those Bible verses in our hearts. All right. Oh, I'm sorry. Beverly, this week's Bible verse is going to be a victory chant. Do you know what victory means?
Like winning?
That's right. When you win something. Have you ever won anything?
Yes.
What did you win?
A game against my brother.
How did you feel?
Good.
It always makes us feel good to win, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so our Bible verse this week is about winning. And we are going to do it kind of like a chant. So you can use one hand, and it's going to be to a rhythm, okay? So I will go ahead and do the whole thing, and then Beverly and I will do it together. All right? Okay, you ready? It goes like this. Thanks be to God. He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:57.
That was cool.
You think you can do that with me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Thanks be to God. He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:57.
Woo!
Yay! All right. Do you know how God gave us? How did we win through Jesus? How did God give us the victory? You have any ideas?
No.
Okay. Well, if you remember, Miss Laurie and Miss Kathy are in our Bible story time. They were talking about how Jesus died on the cross for us.
Oh, I remember now.
Okay. Jesus died on the cross for us, and he covered his blood that he shed on the cross covers all of our sin. Mm-hmm. And Miss Laurie talked about sin. You know, it's the stuff that we do that isn't very pleasing to God, like taking a cookie or telling just a little quiet lie that we don't think is very big, but it still is a sin. So we are so thankful to God that we do have victory through Jesus.
Yes.
It covers all of our sins. All right? Okay, our last activity for our Bible verse is a secret code. Do you know what a secret code is?
I think so.
It's spies sometimes figure out what secret codes are. And so what you're going to do, boys and girls, you have this in your sack this week. There's a code at the bottom of the page. And each little symbol stands for a letter of the Bible verse. So when you see that symbol, and Beverly, I'm going to show you too, when you see the symbol, you're going to write the letter in the top, in the blank. And when you finish, you'll have our secret code Bible verse. But guess what? It's not a secret. Because God can give everyone the victory, not just a few people. We don't want to keep this a secret, do we? We want to share this with everybody we know. All right, Beverly, this is our last time to be together. Oh, are you sad? Oh, it's okay. It's okay. We'll see you again, all right? It's okay. And guess what?
What?
When you get sad, you can go back and remember all the Bible verses that we've learned during this vacation Bible school. And maybe it will help you remember the great times that we had. All right?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, boys and girls. We love you. And we will see you again. Have a great rest of the summer. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hi guys, it's Miss Terry again. Tonight we're gonna make a whale. It didn't look like a whale in here, but we're gonna make a whale. And your verse this week is, thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. That's 1 Corinthians 15:57. And you've been learning in your Bible studies and stuff about that Paul reaches his goal. Well, you're probably saying, how does a whale go with Paul reaching his goal? Well, whales have to swim to certain areas to have their babies every year. They have to swim to other areas for food when temperatures change and stuff like that. So we're going to talk about, a whale reaches his goal just like Paul reached his goal. So we're going to put this whale together. So first, you're going to get these little white pipe cleaners, and you're going to stick these little shiny things to the ends of them. They don't want to stick very good, so my suggestion is you take it and you rub it on the top of your glue stick like this. And get a bunch of glue right there on the end of your pipe cleaner, and then you're going to stick it to the little plastic jewel, like so. Okay. And then your pipe cleaners are going to have to go through this little tiny hole right here. So you're going to take them and put them in the hole, like so. I should have done them all at one time instead of doing them individually, but oh well, this works. This is going to be his water that sprays out of his blowhole. And you're going to turn these and twist them in there and bend them down so that they will stay in place. Like so. And then we're going to put glue around the edge of the whale right here. And then you're going to stick it in your... He has a smiley face, so you need to make sure you point him toward the front of the whale. Like so. And stick him on there like that. I had to hold him there for a minute. So you have two googly eyes. You're going to put glue on the eyes and stick them on. Let's see if I can get his... So, and then you have his fins. So you're going to put glue on those and stick them onto the sides of the whales. And you probably have to leave it sitting for a little while so it can dry. And there is your whale. Oops. So thank you very much, guys, and I'll talk to you all later. Bye.
Slapstick Theater. Paul and Silas. This is Paul.
Oh, hey.
Who told people about Jesus in lots of different places. One day, Paul was walking with his friend Silas.
Hey, yo.
They were being followed by a girl who was controlled by an evil spirit. Her owners used her to make money. After days and days of this happening, Paul got so annoyed that he turned around and told the evil spirit to leave her. So the girl was free.
Woohoo!
But her owners got mad at Paul and Silas because they wouldn't make any money off of her anymore. And they had them thrown in jail. The jailer locked them up.
Oh, man.
Around midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing to God and the other prisoners were listening. Suddenly, there was an earthquake and the chains of all the prisoners fell off.
Oh, what just happened?
But Paul and Silas didn't leave, even though they could have. Several people decided to follow Jesus that night, including the jailer and his whole family. And the next morning, they were released from jail, and the city officials even apologized to them.
Sorry about that.
Paul and Silas encouraged the Christians in the town, and they continued on their mission to tell people about Jesus.
See ya!
You know, I can't believe that we're already at the end.
We're at the end. It's been 5 weeks.
5 weeks. It's been a great 5 weeks. Five great stories. Five activities. There must be a special number with the number five.
Number five. $5 foot long.
Man, there you go. See, yep. Everything is $5, right?
That's right.
$5 craving box.
$5 craving box. That's awesome.
Yeah.
And then you have Five Below. And I've seen some of you kids at Five Below.
That's right. I personally take two kids that I know of to Five Below.
That's right. Because it's great. You go there and you take the balls and you bounce them and you throw them up against the thing and the people throw you out. It's great.
Yeah. I love it. Of course, you know, they kept the kids inside and I had to go stand outside.
So. Yeah, that's right. Well, okay, we got a couple of songs to end it up with. One you know and one you don't. Or no, you know both of you. You know both of these songs. First, we're going to do the Jesus Hokey Pokey. So what you need to do is clear out lots of room in the middle of the room and get your friends and your family that is there with you to come help you do the Jesus Hokey Pokey. Pokey.
Jesus, and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. And that's what it's all about. Put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. You put your right foot in and you shake it all about. You give your heart to Jesus and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your left foot in, your left foot out. You put your left foot in and you shake it all about. You give your heart to Jesus and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. Your heart to Jesus, and that's what it's all about. You put your head in, you put your head out. You put your head in and you shake it all about. You give your heart to Jesus and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your whole self in, you put your whole self out. You put your whole self in and you shake it all about. You give your heart to Jesus and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. And that's what it's all about.
Song that we just did.
That's right.
So now we're going to do and close out with one more fun song, and it's a song we did earlier in the week. It's the Jesus song. So,
get
it, Julie!
Yes.
can do it better. I know you can do it better. So I want you to say it with some conviction, with some oomph, alright? Give me a D!
Activities we gave to you guys. Whew, I don't know about you, but I'm out of breath.
I'm thinking. We might need to call the ambulance.
And need some O2.
O2. Well, we're so glad we had a good time. We're so thankful for all of this. Thankful for all of these folks and others that helped us get this together. We're very thankful for Tori, who taped all of this.
Yay, Tori!
Come on, come out in front of the camera. Taking a long time. All right, Tori! So Tori's been using her gifts and talents this week to make this what it needs to be. So we're thankful for her. Again, we're thankful for all we get to do. If you want to find out more about North Irving Baptist Church, just go to the internet, northirvingbaptist.com, and we have org. northirvingbaptist.org. Okay, so make sure and go there and you'll find out all about the wonderful things we're doing. You want to get our mailing list, just make sure to put something there on the contact part, and we'd love to be able to minister to you more. And hopefully we are going to minister into the new year, and we're looking forward to those opportunities.
Parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, and those of you who participated, thank you so much for allowing us to be inside your homes and to be with your children and mentoring to them and teaching them a little bit about Paul and about Jesus. Thank you.
Right. And we are meeting in church, so if you want to know more about that, call the church. We can tell you what the guidelines are on that. So thank you for being a part, and we'll see you.
Thank you.
Real soon.
Bum-ba-dee-da, 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 bum-ba-dee-da. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then.
Who cares about the
storms? When we're
together, just
pray to Jesus for sunny weather.
Happy trails to you until we meet again.